receiving a probation before judgment, which is not a conviction, which is expungible at a point, and then also talk about that 3-year point after you finish your probation period, when you are eligible to get that off direct. So talk about the difference between getting a probation before judgment up front and a conviction. When either way, you're going to be on probation in the community, and that conviction can hamper you in terms of getting jobs, loans, any kind of services in the community. And that small little distinction in your court file between a conviction and a probation before judgment, if you could address that, and then how long it takes to even expunge your probation before judgment. And then for Ms. Wolfson, the elevation program. I just had a client come into court who was in the elevation program. I'm not attacking any specific judges, but the judge I was in front of had no clue what this program was. And I had this really nice letter presenting, you know, everything he's been doing. I'm not saying that it would have made the ultimate difference in the case, but the court had no clue what I was talking about. So, you know, can we talk about those two issues? Thank you.
Probation before judgment. No, that's two different things. What a stat is, is a lat job, and it basically means to put aside. And so if you've ever received a stat or you've been in a courtroom with a stat, it's an indefinite postponement. And during the first year, it can be reopened by either the state or the defendant. But after the first year, it can only be reopened by for good cause. And after 3 years, it can be expunged. However, it stays on your record forever if you don't get it expunged. And so it will be there. So that's what a stat is. Kind of like an indefinite postponement. It is not pending. For those judges that rule against me, it is not a pending criminal proceeding. I'm just putting it out there. but a probation before judgment, the judge did find you guilty, even for a brief moment. And so that's why sometimes a PPJ has federal ramifications as opposed to in the state, because you were found guilty. But then what the judge does is the judge strikes that guilty finding and puts you on this period of probation. And as long as you successfully complete that probation, the judge will stay as a PPJ. And for expungement purposes, a probation before judgment can be, you can file for an expungement after 3 years from the date of the entry of the PPJ or when you finish probation, whichever is the latest. And the reason why is because in circuit court, you can get a 5-year probation. So if you're on probation for 5 years, even though 3 years has passed, you probably can't. You probably, the judge won't grant it. The stat, you generally have to wait 3 years. But there is a provision in the expungement statute that says that you can file for an expungement at any time for good cause. So even a PPJ and even a stat, you can file earlier than 3 years. I have to convince the judge that there's good cause. One of the changes in the law that I would say we need, especially with probation before judgment, as soon as you successfully complete that probation, you should be able to expunge. You shouldn't have to wait, because the judge can't do anything once your probation period is over. It stays a PPJ. There's no reason why it has to remain.
Actually, there is. You can ask the state's attorney for permission to backdate the probation before judgment from the date that was first entered.
No,
in that instance, that is a way to avoid that wait period. So there is a way to do it, but it's not done often.
No, it's not done very often. And what I found with the probation before judgment is when I file for a good cause, it's very hard to convince the judges to grant the PPJ earlier than 3 years. And that's why I feel like a legislative fix is as soon as you complete your probation, there's no need to even bottle anything with the judge.
Hands up.
Or do anything. Just let that PPJ come off your record. You did everything the judge wanted,
judge
didn't violate. Does that answer your question,
Todd?
Yes,
okay.
Thank you.
Another question for Sam. So the elevation program was started in September of 2014. Around that time, we were invited to come speak to the judiciary. Judge Geller arranged with Judge Pearson for us to come to the bench meeting. Most of the judges were there. Those who weren't there did receive a PowerPoint with the information about the program. There have been several judges who are very familiar with it. Judge Hurd being the champion of elevation. Judge Friedman came in and visited with the women who are currently in the elevation program. We had 190 students have contacted the program, either for a few days or for up to like 9 or 10 months. 44 graduated, 96 have come home. The goal of the program is to reduce the violence on the inside and also to provide people with tools, because when you have resources and support and services, we do better, because jail other than people who have been institutionalized to the point where they don't know how to do anything else. Everyone else wants to do better. They want to do something different. But a lot of people need hope. They need services and support. So of the 96 who had contact, only 9 had new charges and have been rearrested for such. And 50 have reached out to my organization to make people to get services.
And you're now having a funding issue, which is implementing or sort of slowing down your ability to take
care.
And I need you to give me the last word, and then Mr. Ryan.